Hey, how's it going? Shane at Shane Hubber Fit, where we teach you how to lose weight without counting calories or doing exercise that you hate. Today's topic is going to be all about how to stop cravings without using a ton of willpower or over-restricting your food choices. So the way I'd like to start this video is by going over some overview principles, some very basics that you can get started with right away. All right, so let's go over number one, which is improve the quality of your nutrition. If you're experiencing really intense cravings, one of the things that you probably need to improve is the quality of nutrition on a consistent basis. I like to use the analogy of really strong cravings being like someone yelling in your ear like a foot away. It's really, really loud, it's really intense, and it's hard to resist. So sometimes it's just better to give in. But when you give in, if you are consistently overdoing it, if you're overeating that food, then it's going to lead to gains in body fat and just an overall poor nutrition plan. So if you can improve the quality of nutrition, a lot of times what you'll do is you'll quiet that loud voice that's yelling at you or that strong craving because you're already satisfied by the nutrition and the quality of your food. The second tip that I like to say is don't restrict the types of food that you eat. Don't restrict carbs, don't restrict fats, don't restrict proteins, don't even restrict processed versus unprocessed food. So you can still eat junk food, but you have to kind of organize it in an 80-20 lifestyle, where 80% of the time you're trying to eat as much nutritious food as you can, and 20% of the time you're having kind of these fun junk foods. And this could be on a daily basis. You know, you can have one or two squares of chocolate, or you can have a small amount of ice cream every single day if it fits within the calories that you're trying to consume, and you can still enjoy life and still have these foods. Over-restriction a lot of times actually makes cravings worse. So if you notice that you're trying to eat clean all the time and your cravings are only getting more intense, it would be better to shift to an 80-20 lifestyle where you're 80% of the time eating, you know, really good nutritious food, but 20% of the time you're giving yourself kind of that little junk food that you really like. Like for me, it's peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. It's not really junk food, but the calories can really add up. Or it's a couple squares of dark chocolate, which are one of my favorites. So allow yourself to have any type of food that you want, but be smart about the portions you're consuming them in. All right, tip number three is add more bulk foods to your nutrition. So what do I mean by bulk foods? Well, you want high volume, low calorie foods. So this would be something like berries and watermelon and lean meats and, you know, broccoli, cauliflower, your green vegetables essentially, because you can eat a lot of these foods and really fill up very easily without the calories stacking up. And what this allows you to do is when you feel full and you feel satiated from a meal, you're less likely to have really intense cravings. It doesn't mean you won't have some cravings, but it just means that your intensity of those cravings will be really low. So instead of someone yelling at you, it feels like someone's like talking very softly, or it's kind of like a whisper. All right, so those are my three kind of overview tips that you can use to start from a basic level on how to reduce and stop your cravings. All right, so let's get into some more specific cravings. Let's first talk about how to stop sweet cravings. Now, the best way to stop sweet cravings goes back to not restricting or over-restricting your food choices. If you're constantly restricting everything that's sweet, your cravings are just gonna be more intense. So make sure that you include kind of a sweet little treat, especially if you have a sweet tooth, every other day or maybe every day in a small amount to help curb that sweet tooth. A lot of times all it takes is a taste and a small amount to curb that craving. The best way to do this, by the way, is to do it after a meal. Like, you don't necessarily want to have something sweet as a snack because your likelihood of wanting to eat more and overdoing it dramatically increases. So what I like to do is I like to have two squares of dark chocolate after dinner. And that's just kind of my, you know, everyday thing. I fit that in with my daily calorie amount and it works out really well. Another quick tip for sweet cravings is have some fruit. Fruit is obviously sweet, and the reason why I recommend fruit is because it's kind of a more controlled amount of calories. There's water and fiber in fruit, so you're less likely to overeat those, but still be able to curb your sweet craving. All right, so the next common craving is carbs. How to stop carb cravings. And kind of like the sweet cravings example, if you're over-restricting how many carbs you eat, like way over-restricting, like maybe doing like the keto diet or an extremely low calorie diet or extremely low carb diet, your likelihood of craving carbs is dramatically going to increase. So by giving yourself permission to have carbs, obviously in a controlled manner, just like everything else, your cravings, the intensity of your cravings is going to go down. I've actually worked with quite a few people who are quote unquote recovering from the keto diet. And this is one of the first things that we do is we slowly introduce more carbs into their diet and their carb cravings dramatically decrease. All right, so the next big one is how to stop junk food cravings. junk food cravings are probably the most prevalent type of craving that you'll experience, and it goes back to the quality of your nutrition. If the quality of your nutrition is poor, you're gonna experience more intense cravings for junk food. You gotta remember that junk foods and processed foods are engineered. There's millions and millions of dollars behind making sure that you overeat these junk foods, all right? They combine sugar, salt, and fat, or some combination of those three, and those for your brain is like an extreme pleasure and reward. So your brain is like, eat more, eat more, eat more. It used to be evolutionarily advantageous to have salt, sugar, and fat in a diet or have that in some type of food. So your brain automatically wants to overeat it. So by simply improving the quality of nutrition and the balance of your nutrition, one of the things that you're going to see is that your cravings for junk foods are going to decrease. Now, I'll never say that they'll completely go away because I just don't think that that's always the case. But I will say that if it feels like on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the most, your cravings are a 9 for junk food, it's gonna be reduced down to like a 2, 3, or a 4. So that's why it's so important to try to improve the quality of your nutrition first, especially if you're trying to reduce the amount of calories you consume, because improving the quality of nutrition makes everything a lot easier, whether it's cravings or losing body fat. All right, so the next most common craving is salt cravings. And I'll go ahead and just say it straight out, you do not need to restrict salt. Now, if you are someone who has hypertension or high blood pressure, please consult your doctor before taking this advice. But if you're just an average human being who's been told to restrict the amount of salt that you consume, hear me out on this. If you're adding your own salt to your own food, you really don't have to worry much about it, because our bodies and our tongues, especially in our brains, will tell us when we've had too much salt. There's actually an adverse reaction to having too much salt. It'll taste disgusting. You don't need to worry about getting too much salt. Your body will tell you when you get too much salt. Now, if you're eating a lot of processed foods where they pump sodium and pump tons of salt in those foods to make them taste better because the quality of that food is so bad, then yes, you need to be mindful of that, because obviously that's a whole different system. But if you're adding your own salt, your sea salt, your Himalayan salt, or my favorite Redmond's real salt to your own food, you're gonna be fine, because your body will tell you when you've gotten too much. All right, so the last most common craving is nighttime cravings. So whether it's after dinner or it's late night, this is another very common type of craving. And this is more about when than what, but most of the time when you're eating late at night, you're not having chicken breasts and rice and broccoli, you're having some kind of junk food. The best thing that I've seen work for me and my clients is that you wanna make sure that the quality of your nutrition in the early part of the day is on point. Because typically speaking, if you're over-restricting how much you eat in the middle of the day or at the beginning of the day, sometimes that can lead to overeating at night. Now, I've got nothing against things like intermittent fasting or having, you know, one meal a day if that works for you. But if you start to notice that you're binge eating or you're overeating a lot of processed foods at night, you might want to reconsider this approach or try to fine tune it. If you are doing intermittent fasting, make sure that the quality of your nutrition is extremely important to you, and try to do your best to follow that 80-20 lifestyle, because yes, at the end of the day, calories might be the only thing that really matters to you right now if you're trying to lose weight. But at the same time, if your behavior is such that you're actually overeating at night, then that is going to affect the overall amount of calories that you consume. So just be mindful of that and try to improve the quality of your nutrition early in the day. If you're intermittent fasting, your first meal should be really, really important in terms of quality of nutrition. If you're not intermittent fasting and you're eating kind of a standard 3 square meals a day, then again, just make sure the quality of nutrition is on point. All right, so that is my video on cravings. I hope that helps solve a lot of the problems, gives you some direction, and gives you something to prioritize and focus on. Thanks a ton for watching this video. If you don't mind, please hit that like button so that this video can get out to more people. And if you know somebody has really intense cravings or struggles with cravings, share this video with them. And if you want to see more videos from me in the future, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And then if you hit that bell, it'll notify you when I release new videos. All right, thanks a ton for watching today's video. I will see you in a future video.